Australia's top makeup artists. If there's something about makeup they don't know, it is not worth knowing, basically. Yes. John Australian asks, how you guys got started? What was your big break? And you asked the first Rae Morris.
Okay, so my career happened accidentally. I always say it was 2 seconds in every candle's life that completely changed my life. I was doing hair for a pageant in Istanbul. She was there. I'd never done makeup before. The makeup artist went through tears. She looked at me. I looked at those beautiful lips. And she would tear up. And then I didn't say no to her. I was very intimidated.
She's very intimidated. She stole my mobile phone once, by the way.
And that was it.
How these have changed in the last decade.
with it, and I kind of decided that I wanted to really focus on makeup. And then I got to know people like Justin Smith, Mark Bessler, who was a new stylist for Bazaar, for me. And as soon as I started working with those guys, you know, I initially been starving and had no money, and then I started working with them, and then suddenly I went from nothing to big, doing all magazines, and here we are now.
Amazing makeup that you had in your head, it was fantastic. If the brief was something else, or I remember she saw her in an interview, and what I love is sometimes being a makeup artist is doing nothing. So doing nothing on the face is as important as what you do. So what you don't do is really important. Deciding to do no makeup is as important. And I know when I started when I was young, I watched it every time on the face at once. But it's what I feel really important is to make that look just beautiful. Like, with no makeup, it's as powerful that a girl that does full makeup, because it tells people your taste and what you find beautiful. And beautiful can be about something with no makeup on. Does that make sense?
And you know what is such a good point is when you've got an outfit and you've really been trying to work out the makeup, and there's so much of this, you have to look at the outfit, you have to look at the lighting that the photographer's doing.
Excellent, you know, to make that. You know, it's just a totally different show.
was so useful for our new craft. Being a lesbian, Asian woman, menopausal woman, it was sleep time. You've got to be amazing. And my other advice is starting out makeup, just done a course, please don't start with weddings. A woman's decision on how she looks on her wedding day, or if I had to have eye surgery, all the patients of my doctor, I hope you just didn't do a course. So, brides, they don't have the choice to have to take off what they want. But I see so many makeups just start there because they want to make money. And I promise in 5 years' time, same, they're unspired, they don't like it, they're exhausted. So don't do the primes. How much do you try? You said don't. Do it when you're really skilled.
That's great advice. After talking to you guys today, so we have given you a really tricky 5-star challenge. So Rae's going to do a fantastically flawless 5-minute face. He's going to talk us through it as she goes. And then there's a baton passing to Liz. And I'm going to be that individual that goes, you've got 1 inch. So don't hold that against me.
So before what I did is I just, before we came on stage, just got some of my solar and quickly cleanse. We all think our eyes right now, because everyone's thinking their eyes. It's one of the oiliest parts of your face. However, one of your T-zone is not really oily, and that's why I show you have such an eyebrow on stage. So I make sure there's not oil on your eyes. I've done my solar, and I'm just putting some skin circles for hydration and calm skin down. The reason why I control this process, I need to know everything that's on that skin. We have oil-based products, and you know, some women think pretty nice, but you know, it's really big oil, and then everything's going to fall apart. So I moisturize first, and I match foundation. Just a little bit, when you go get foundation, where you match it, just point for me, where you match it. Okay, chest health. Okay, because if you do a foundation, you'll never stop with the pain side of your body, it's more like the side of your face, and too high. And always when you finish your foundation, chin to shoulder, take a photo with them without flush, it will be the same color. Say, face the mind the same. This is another subject I was on. The same mask is moisturizers. One of my brushes, I have a brush range that's made by the last thing in Japanese mask that they find in the world. So I'm just going to polish out. If you've got any imperfections or blemishes, I don't care about that. I want the good skin to look amazing. I have macro lens frames on, which is the same as the camera, so I can see every detail. And what I'll do, if I have any blemishes, foundation is going to help out 50-80% of them anyway. So what I do, I get the base on, I'm going to do the makeup and then come back in and you can see all the imperfections. Or I'm talking now, when I'm over with the cold sticky, a really good tip with concealer, anything under the eye, when it's a scar that's indented, get a concealer or brown shade lighter, however that is. If you're covering a blemish or a raised area, your concealer should match your skin tone exactly. So I'm just putting a little bit of concealer, a great trick. If you want coverage, let it sit there for a minute to get to body heat, then smooth it out. My trick sometimes is getting a foundation that's stronger than what you want, but use less of it. I'm just going to polish that in. So, just on top.
Are you brushing magnetic?
Yeah, well, it's first painted in magnetic. And the reason for this, it actually was a fashion week as well in Paris. They can be just as big. Brush felt when you bend over. They did. It was when you travel with them. When you travel with them, if they go upside down in a suitcase, they're destroyed. And also hygiene. So I can throw 150 brushes into 200 on a base so small. They stand up, they are falling over. I watched women's bathrooms, my friends have their brushes, and they're sitting in the sink with a bit of hair while they're there. So it's a hygiene thing, they're banging, that's it. So I can't even know a lot about it before.
Where can you get your brushes from?
So Rae Morris.com, Metta Porter, Selfridges, and then it was a few. Rae Morris.com, I can divert you from there. So it has to be quite amazing. To make it a high-end makeup brush, it's between 5 and 10 steps. To make a liquid brush, it starts at 70 to 100. My brush starts at 80. So 70 steps. And what liquid brush is basically mean to you? would you call a highlight and then jump off the stage?
You're doing well, I'm having a cool time.
First
stop and it will not move. It can stay off for a week and it didn't move. So next I'm putting my gel eyeliner, and like this I'm going to get right into the base of the lashes and make sure there's no little gaps.
Did you do that?
black on air. I was with my little sister. You keep talking about my hair crush on black paint. Do not let it run. That's right. Smiling with you, you have to be playing to wake till 5 or 6. And I turned around and my sister's getting the job of house paint and playing a bad job. And that's just what I got my girl. It's a nice hair crush today. I was assisting Molly and I knew I'd never work again, so I just left. I didn't stay. Because I thought, I'm going to punish myself so much when my career is over, why can't I humiliate myself more?
So you walked off the
job. I said, Mark Ray, you know, I said, hi, this is what I've done, I don't want to tell that, I'm going home, I left.
Wow. It's such a big story. My family is black house.
She likes house paint. It's very hard.
Yeah, I want to do a package.
Yeah.
And it came off. I'm
to make it look cute by more pointy or soft and rounded.
What's your little pen?
Do you know that, right?
I don't have one.
Girls on her team and their home jobs.
most appropriate thing is the source of your knowledge, and Instagram is such so inspirational. But basically, the message is look outside that to get creative.
But if you ever
slip
in a shoe and you want to get a reference, just show them a picture of Kate Moss.
Yeah, yeah.
Stuff that the world's best pros would have, that's every